Well, now to a story about reconnecting people with their communities. In Adelaide's southern suburbs, there's a great new program which is bringing people together who were once isolated and lonely.
It's marvellous. I was so isolated after my husband died. I found friends.
So you either sit home and do nothing or you get out and meet people, and that's what I prefer doing.
I'd hate to be without the circle of friends. And I
never thought I'd feel this way. 84-year-old great-grandmother Joyce cared for her husband Daryl for 9 years. When he passed away 6 months ago, Joyce found herself at home alone and isolated from her community.
It is hard, because we had 65 years together, and that's a lifetime, you know, and then suddenly it's gone.
But Joyce was determined not to be consumed by her loneliness, taking the vital first step to find out more about the circle of friends.
And I think that was where the circle came in for me. Had it not been for that, I don't know what I'd have done.
Joyce is now an active member of the Circle of Friends. As well as attending various social outings, she also has Sarah and Rachel, two international students, to her house regularly for afternoon tea and a chat.
And then we felt actually it's a good chance for us as an international student to know more about Australian culture. Knowing you can always count on me, for sure.
Joyce has also made a wonderful friend through the circle, 77-year-old great-grandmother Dorothy.
We found a few new shops and a few new items too.
It's been lovely just to meet older people with the same interests.
Amid their social outings, Dorothy and Joyce enjoy making boxes of joy together. Personal, customised gift boxes to lift the spirits of other older people in the community.
Notebook.
Yep.
Dorothy. Joy. That's great. Wow, you've finished the box already.
Vanessa Lean is the Circle of Friends coordinator. The program was initiated through the Office for the Aging to provide support for older people in the community. It's managed by Masonic Homes Community Care.
So we've got a lot of changes both socially and within family structures, which means that people do often feel very alone.
But slowly, by talking to older people, Vanessa discovered that there were huge possibilities for each older person to put value on what they could offer the community.
It was seeing what they saw as important and beginning to develop a pathway of value so that with support that can be expressed.
Or you're doing something different.
It was with this open approach Vanessa discovered 87-year-old Nora would love the opportunity to interact with small children.
I have no children of my own, nor grandchildren, so they have filled a void in my life.
So for the last 6 months, Nora has been visiting the Dunbar Terrace Kindergarten at Glenelg East, where both she and the children have a wonderful time together.
It's a great joy and a privilege to be with these little children. Oh, they've given me so much happiness. They really have. Went to see in that shoe. Fancy going to see in a shoe. Would you like to do that?
Yeah, what do you think of Nora?
She's beautiful.
We just like the way that the children just interact with her, and she's got an extremely warm and caring manner with them too. And they just spontaneously go up, they make her things, and so have made her feel really welcome.
Dunbar Terrace Kindergarten Director Sandy says it's been a pleasure to facilitate Nora's visits to the kindy. She didn't hesitate to welcome her. Celebratory afternoon tea at Parliament House, the Circle of Friends were given a pleasant surprise.
Little bit of good news that I have for you today is that we are going to extend your funding.
I would like to see this grow. It's worth keeping.
Circle of Friends, I can't imagine what I would have done if I hadn't had them. They've been marvellous.